Hello students, let's have the numericals of the chapter 12, electromagnetic induction. Now let's see the important formulas of the chapter electromagnetic induction that will be used here to solve the numericals. As per the Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction, we come to know that whenever there is a change in the magnetic flux associated with a coil, an EMF is induced in the coil. And as per the second law, the magnitude of induced EMF is directly proportional to the rate of change of magnetic flux through the coil there. Hence, here the magnitude of the induced EMF is to be given as magnitude of E is directly proportional to the rate of change of magnetic flux to the coil. So it is to be given as d phi by dt. And this is valid for one turn of the wire there. When there are n number of turns are there in a coil, then magnitude of induced EMF is to be given as n into d phi by dt. Then the magnetic flux is to be given as a scalar product of B and A. So it is to be given as phi is equal to BA cos theta, where theta is the angle between area and the direction of the magnetic field of induction. After that, we had seen the EMF induced in a circuit whose parts move in a fixed magnetic field, which is to be given as E is equal to BLV, where B is the uniform magnetic induction, L is the length of the conductor, and V is the velocity with which the conductor is to be moved in this magnetic field of induction. Then we had seen EMF induced in a rotating rod also, which is to be given as E is equal to half B omega L square, where B is the uniform magnetic induction, L is the length of the conductor, and omega is the angular velocity of the rotating rod in a magnetic field of induction. We had also determined the rate of mechanical work done in pulling a loop through a magnetic field, which is to be given as P is equal to V square L square V upon R, where B is the uniform magnetic induction, L is the length of the conductor or a loop, V is the velocity of the loop or a conductor with which it is moving in a uniform magnetic induction, and R is the collective resistance of the loop or a conductor. Then we have studied about the self-inductance. The production of induced EMF in the circuit or a coil itself on account of a change in current in it is termed as the phenomenon of self-inductance. And here we come to know that the magnetic flux linked with the circuit or a coil itself B phi, which is directly proportional to the current in it, that is I. So here we can say that as phi is directly proportional to I, so phi is equal to L I, where this L is the constant of proportionality and is termed as self-inductance or coefficient of self-induction of the coil. Then by using the same phenomenon, the EMF induced in a coil or a circuit, the self-induced EMF is given as per the Faraday's law is equal to minus L di upon dt. As EMF induced is to be given as minus d phi by dt as per the Faraday's law. The value of phi we are getting as L I, Hence, it is to be taken as L is constant, I is to be changed with respect to time there. So, E is equals to minus L di upon dt there. Where negative sign indicates that the induced current or induced EMF tries to oppose the change or the cause which produced it. After that, we have determined inductance per unit length near the middle of a long solenoid, which is to be given as capital L upon L is equal to nu 0 n square in bracket pi d square upon 4. Here d is the diameter of solenoid there and n is the number per unit length, and capital L upon L is said to be a inductance per unit length there. Then we had seen the concept of mutual inductance. As mutual inductance is the interaction of one coil's magnetic field on another coil, as it induces a voltage in the adjacent coil there. When the EMF is induced into an adjacent coil situated within the same magnetic field, the EMF is said to be induced magnetically, inductively, or by mutual induction. The symbol is given as capital M. Then, when two or more coils are magnetically linked together by a common magnetic flux, they are said to have a property of mutual inductance. And hence, here we can write the magnetic flux linked with the coils is directly proportional to current I in it, and that's why we can write it as phi is equal to mi, where m is said to be the coefficient of the mutual inductance. And the mutually induced EMF E is to be given as per the Faraday's law minus m di upon dt. Next, the turn per unit length we are considering as small n, which is to be given as capital N upon L, where capital N is the total turns of the wire there. Next, we had seen coefficient of coupling K, which is a measure of the portion of flux that reaches coil 2, which is in the vicinity of coil 1. Greater the coefficient of coupling means greater will be the mutual inductance. The two coil 1 and 2 with self-inductance L1 and L2 is coupled with mutual inductance and is given as K is equal to M upon square root L1 into L2. After that, we had seen transformer, which is an electrical device that converts low alternating voltage at high current to high alternating voltage at low current and vice versa. And it is based on the principle of mutual induction, that is, whenever the magnetic flux linked with the coil changes, an EMF is induced in the neighboring coil. Then the induced EMF in the secondary coil is to be given as ES. ES represents induced EMF in the secondary coil is equals to NS into d phi upon dt, where NS is the number of turns of the secondary coil there. And the induced EMF in a primary coil is to be represented as EP, and it is to be given as EP is equal to minus NP into d phi by dt, where NP represents number of turns in the primary coil. Then there is a relation between voltage and current in the transformer, which is to be given as ES upon EP is equal to NS upon NP, as well as ES upon EP is equal to IP upon IS. As ES and EP is the EMF induced in the secondary and primary coil, NS and NP is the number of turns in the secondary and primary coil, IP and IS is the current in primary and secondary coil there. Hence, we can write ES upon EP is equal to NS upon NP is equal to IP upon IS. So these are the important formulas for the chapter electromagnetic induction that will be used to solve the numericals. Let's have the next unsolved numerical from the textbook. Question number 7 is, a long solenoid consisting of 1.5 into 10 raised to 3 turns per meter has an area of cross section of 25 cm square. A coil C consisting of 150 turns NC is wound tightly around the center of the solenoid. Calculate for a current of 3 ampere in the solenoid. A, the magnetic flux density at the center of the solenoid. B, the flux linkage in the coil C. C, the average EMF induced in coil C if the current in the solenoid is reversed in direction in a time of 0.5 seconds. Here, it is given that the long solenoid consisting of 1.5 into 10 raised to 3 turns per meter and its cross-sectional area is given 25 centimeter square. So this area which is given in CGS system, we have to convert in SI system in meter, and hence the area becomes 25 into 10 raised to minus 4 meter square. Then it is given a coil C which consists of 150 turns. It is to be tightly wound around the center of the given solenoid, and hence we have to calculate for the given current which is to be flowing 3 ampere in the solenoid. We have to calculate first of all the magnetic flux density at the center of the solenoid. Then next we have to calculate how much flux linkage in the coil C of 150 turns there, and then in a given interval of time 0.5 second, what will be the average EMF induced in a coil C? Now let's see the solution as it is given. N, which indicates the number of turns per meter, is given 1.5 into 10 raised to 3 turns per meter for a given solenoid. Area A is to be converting into meter square, and hence it comes 25 into 10 raised to minus 4 meter square. The current is to be flowing in a solenoid is 3 ampere. Total number of turns for a coil C is 150 and time is given 0.5 second. We have to find out first of all the magnetic flux density B. Second, flux linkage for a given number of turns. And third, we have to determine the average EMF induced for a given interval of time 0.5 seconds. The formula we are going to use to determine the magnetic flux density, we are using the formula B is equal to nu 0 Ni. Second, to determine the flux linkage for n number of turns in a coil, it will be N phi. And third, to determine the average EMF induced in a coil in a given interval of time 0.5 second is change in flux per unit time. So by using the formula 1, which is B is equals to nu 0 Ni, let's substitute the value. The value of nu 0 is 4 pi into 10 raised to minus 7 unit. Hence it is to be written as 4 into 3.142 into 10 raised to minus 7. Value of N is given 1.5 into 10 raised to 3 turns per meter. And the current flowing in a solenoid is given as 3 ampere. Let's substitute this value in the formula B is equal to nu 0 Ni. And when we are calculating it, when we are calculating this multiplication, we are getting the value as 56.56 into 10 raised to minus 4. And hence finally, we can write down the answer like 5.656 into 10 raised to minus 3. And here we are representing our answer after the decimal point. There should be only two digits. So the value come to us, the magnetic flux density B will be 5.66 into 10 raised to minus 3 Tesla. Now next, by using the formula N phi, where we are going to determine the flux linkage for the given number of turns in a coil C. It is to be given as N phi, where N is the number of turn is given 150, and phi is to be given as a product of B and A. Then substitute the value of the given physical quantities. N is given 150. The value of B we had determined, which comes to us 5.66 into 10 raised to minus 3. And the area is given 25 into 10 raised to minus 4. Let's solve this multiplication, and hence we are getting our answer. The flux linkage for a given number of turns of the coil, which is 150, is 2.12 into 10 raised to minus 3 Weber. After that, by using the formula change in flux per unit time, we can determine the EMF induced in a coil there for a given interval of time t, which is 0.5 second. So here change in flux we are getting as 2 into the value of the flux linkage we are obtaining as 2.12 into 10 raised to minus 3 there, which is to be divided by 0.5. When we are solving this ratio, we are getting the value of induced EMF as 8.48 into 10 raised to minus 3 volt. And hence we can write on our final answer, first that we had calculated the magnetic flux density B that we are getting as 5.66 into 10 raised to minus 3 Tesla. Then second, we had determined the flux linkage, which is to be obtained as 2.12 into 10 raised to minus 3 Weber. And last, the induced EMF we are getting as 8.48 into 10 raised to minus 3 volt. The next unsolved numerical from the textbook, question number 8, is a search coil having 2000 turns with area 1.5 cm square is placed in a magnetic field of 0.60 Tesla. The coil is moved rapidly out of the field in a time of 0.2 seconds. Calculate the induced EMF across the search coil. Here it is given that a search coil having the number of turns 2000 with area 1.5 cm square, as here the unit is given in CGS system that we have to convert in SI system, and this search coil is to be placed in a magnetic field of induction 0.60 Tesla. It is to be observed that the coil is moved rapidly and comes out of the field in a time of 0.2 second. So here we have to calculate how much EMF is induced across the search coil when it is to be moving in a magnetic field of induction, that is 0.60 Tesla. Let's have the solution. As capital N is given 2000, area is given 1.5 centimeter square that we have to convert in SI system, and hence it comes 1.5 into 10 raised to minus 4 meter square. Value of B is given 0.60 Tesla, and the time interval is given 0.2 second. Here we have to find out the induced EMF E in the search coil, and the formula we are going to use as for the n number of turns, E is to be given as n d phi by dt. As flux is nothing but the product of magnetic field of induction and area, so here the formula comes as nb delta A upon delta t there. Let's substitute the values in this equation. So value of n is 2000, b is given 0.60 Tesla, area is given, as change in area will be 1.5 into 10 raised to minus 4 minus 0, as area of the coil remains same as it is given 1.5 into 10 raised to minus 4 over there, and the time is given over there 0.2 second. So here we have to substitute the value and calculate it. So we are getting the value of induced EMF as 0.9 volt. And hence we can write down our final answer. The induced EMF is 0.9 volt. The next unsolved numerical from the textbook. Question number 9 is, an aircraft of wing span of 50 meter flies horizontally in Earth's magnetic field of 6 into 10 raised to minus 5 Tesla at a speed of 400 meter per second. Calculate the EMF generated between the tips of the wings of the aircraft. Here it is given that an aircraft of wing span having the length 50 meter, which is to be flies horizontally in the magnetic field of induction 6 into 10 raised to minus 5 Tesla, and the speed is given 400 meter per second. So here, as the aircraft is flies horizontally in the Earth's magnetic field, so angle theta will be 90 degree, and here we have to calculate the EMF generated between the tips of the wings of the aircraft. Let's see the solution. As it is given, L is 50 meter, B is 6 into 10 raised to minus 5 Tesla, and V is 400 meter per second. And we have to find induced EMF E by using the formula E is equal to B L V sine theta. As angle theta is 90 degree, that's why sine 90 degree will be 1. And we are using the formula E is equal to BLV there. Next, by using the formula here, we have to substitute the values of B, L and V. B is there, 6 into 10 raised to minus 5. L is given 50 and V is 400. So over there, here we have to calculate this multiplication, and finally we are getting the induced EMF is 1.2 volt. And finally we can write down our answer. The induced EMF between tips of the wings is 1.2 volt.